Hello and welcome to the cryptocurrency news channel. If you want to join me on my live stream, check out the links in my description and comments below. Today we're actually going to talk about the most important trade and why in Bitcoin altcoin trading. It's probably extremely important in Bitcoin cash, Bitcoin fiat trading as well, but especially Bitcoin altcoin trading. I'm going to tell you why. We know that all altcoins follow Bitcoin, so Bitcoin altcoin trading a lot of times is not as profitable as Bitcoin cash trading, but it is a lot safer. And for that reason, the most important trade, it's not being able to read charts. It is not TA. Although that does help a little bit. It's not charts. It's not TA. It's not like insight or anything. It's actually just simple patience. I'll tell you why. Most altcoins in the last 2-3 years, maybe even before that, in terms of Bitcoin ratio, after they've gone up, if you wait a couple of months, they'll always go down and you can buy in for cheaper. The thing is, like, if you basically sold XRP at, like, you know, like 2800 and it goes up to 3200 and you're regretting, you don't buy in at 3200, even if it stays at 3200 for about a month or so. And I know a lot of people that actually did FOMO in like that. And if you do that, you are going to lose out in Bitcoin altcoin trading because it will go down afterwards. Remember back in 2018, right after XRP came out, so many people FOMO'd in. Like, even when it came down from its height of like 70 cents, like dropped to 50 cents, people were like, oh, it's going to go up again so much. And especially in November, once it held, they were like, oh, 589, awesome. It's going to take off and never come back down. What happened? Bam, it went back down. Same thing with VET the next year. Like, once the summit actually happened, you know, people are like, oh my gosh, it's going up to 138, like 150 sats. There's some big announcement coming. They're going to have like super massive giant blobs of utility coming in. It's never coming back down. What happened? Bam, it came back down. Same thing when VET had that Walmart thing coming. You know, like, went up to past a penny. They're like, oh my gosh, Walmart's going to give millions of transactions, millions and millions of transactions, then it's going to go way up. What happened? Bam, Binance happened and it went way, way down. Same thing with, like, you know, VET in the last November pump. Like, oh my gosh, utility is actually coming in. Like, some of the smarter people actually caught on. They're like, nah, it's going to go back down. This is just like a FOMO pump because of the news. And realistically, like, they're really not going to, you know, all of a sudden get like 37 million VETHO burn. And what happened afterwards? Bam, it came back down, just like with everything else. Same thing with, like, you know, last year's XRP Swell conference. It's like, oh my gosh, they're talking about global disruption and trade. And dang, XRP, like, ratio against BTC has gone up 2x. Now, those are fools, man. What happened? Bam, it came back down. Every single time it has come back down, not just for those two coins, but for all the other coins as well. Like, ICX had a giant, you know, come up at the beginning of the year. And what happened afterwards? The ratio actually retraced back down. It hasn't completely retraced back down fully. I'm not really sure if it will. If you sold at the bottom, that might just be bad luck. But the thing is, like, if you sold partway up, as long as you wait, you're going to get that buy-in once again because everything follows BTC. And traders, like, a lot of swing traders, like veteran swing traders, basically base their trades on this. They're like, oh, you know, like, the bottom was here and the top was here. So if the coin is, like, still near the top, we're not going to buy in yet. We're going to wait until the bottom. And eventually, without the momentum of those traders buying back in, like, with every, like, with them actually starting to take profits out, that will actually retrace towards the bottom. It might take weeks or even months for that to happen, but you just have to have the patience to actually stick it out. Like, it doesn't matter, like, what you think about the coin. It generally will retrace because, like, a lot of those people, even if they have little bumps in the way, they will actually retrace. The worst thing that you can do in, like, BTC altcoin swing trading is actually have favorites. If you're, like, so in love with the coin, you don't want to, like, if you're, like, a hold forever person, I guess it's okay to be in love with the coin. Actually, it's not, because then you won't sell off. Even when it hyper moons, you think it's going to moon anymore and you're not going to take profits and you're going to lose all those profits. But especially if you're a swing trader, you cannot have a favorite coin. You have to be opportunistic. Because, like, if you see a coin that's at the top of this range, you have to sell that coin and buy another one that's at the bottom of the range. And that's how you actually make money. Like, you know, Theta was actually quite low a while ago, you know, at 6 cents. And let's say, you know, like, I don't know what's a coin. Like, maybe I think, like, HBARS was actually quite high a while ago. So you sell out of HBARS, buy Theta. They've both been doing pretty well, but Theta's doing a lot more well because it was, you know, towards the bottom of the trading range and not the top of the trading range. Same thing with ICX when it ran up to like, 60 cents or something, 50 cents. You got to sell out at that point and sell out back into BTC. And now the BTC ratio is quite low again. So, that took about 3 months. And a lot of people don't have the steady hands to actually just hold on for 3 months until it comes back. So be prepared to wait for like, 2, 3 months at least, maybe even 5, 6 months, or even a year before you swing trade back. Because at some point it is going to fall back because like it just works in pattern because that's how a lot of the major swing traders actually work. And that's why I don't do day trading because day trading time frame is extremely short. Within a day, like you may not be able, once you miss it, you may not be able to get it back and you might have to buy back at a loss. But if you do swing trading just means you're swinging at X amount of time. Usually like for me, it's a month to 3 months to make a successful trade, unless there's like an opportunity that just like comes right up where something goes way up and then comes way down. Sometimes it's between a month and 3 months, but like after last swell, I had to wait for like 4 or 5 before buying back into XRP and buying back. Yeah, I had to wait 4 or 5 before buying back into XRP at significantly like lower Satoshi ratio than I actually sold out at. So the thing is, like, if you wait, especially for these major coins that don't have like that much news coming up to them, because another major partnership is not going to push XRP price up all that much. Even if it is Bank of America, it might FOMO like 20% and then just drop back down. And at that, let's peak of that FOMO is when you actually want to sell out. Same thing with VeChain, like with Walmart, it did FOMO up, but then it just came back down. So like, when those partnerships are announced, in the day after the partnership announced, or the day or two after the partnership announced, is prime time to sell. You can't think it's going to go out forever because that one partnership all of a sudden isn't going to give it massive amounts of utility. Even if the partner integrates it and it's a real partnership, it's eventually like it's going to come back down because it's going to take years to actually integrate it. And we're seeing that with a lot of the ODL stuff, and we're seeing that with a lot of the VeChain stuff. Like the burn is slowly going up, and ODL is going to take probably 4 or 5 years to really activate to where it actually has an actual effect on price. So that is what I have to say for today. Let me know what you think. Like and subscribe and hit that bell notifications button. Thank you and have a nice day.